One of my favorite maps as well. So aside from that first choke point, that can be a little aggravating, but once you get past it, it's a lot of fun. So we're gonna see Retzy early on playing his one of his go-to heroes in the Tracer, poking in on the left side. Sweep around looking for his counterpart, Waffletastic, who has also had some pretty big moments. Of course, they are running the Hydration Pharah, which has been huge right up there with Jake at times so far in this tournament. It gets direct hit midair by Spirit. Can he counter this back? Spirit looking for the pick, has the help of the Zen Orb, but has to land these rockets for it to do any good. Can't quite connect. Hydration still yet to finish him off, though. The Pharah battle's taking a while, but Hydration finally nails him. Will finish him off, and will stabilize this defense.
Well, when it comes to a Pharah battle, the one thing you need to keep in mind is that you always want the higher ground advantage. You want to be the second person to use Shift, so you can always be shooting down at least at terrain or the ground, trying to get that splash damage, because direct hits, of course, are nice. You can finish off an enemy Pharah with just two of them, but they are very, very hard to secure. So as long as you have that height advantage, your enemy's going to be shooting up wildly, unable to splash you, and you'll be able to shoot down and finish them off. But here we go. The attackers are back, and they're choosing the left side route this time around.
Yeah, off the Tracer for Retzy, on to the Soldier. They want more tools to deal with Hydration. Will it be enough? Waffletastic sweeping around from behind, does bring down Locke, has the Sticky available, can go in for this Pulse Bomb when he sees an opportunity. Could really stagger this offense, but while he's looking for that, pickoffs are happening elsewhere. Gets the Retzy kill, needs a bit more. Deathrow fairly low, not turning for Spirit, who also finds himself between a Mercy and a Pharah, and not in a good way. We'll end up going down. Hydration with the Rocket Barrage ready. Could go for follow-up. Wilson on the back again. So kind of discombobulated effort there by the offense.
I think Hydration and V are starting their own Mile High Club, where you have to get 6 kills in a row while being a mile in the air, because they have not come down from there the entire map so far. They're just raining rockets down from way, way up there, and it's up to Spirit, really, to try and contest against that. X-Retzy really can't even get line of sight as Soldier without just being totally exposed to the rest of the team, and Midnight bites the dust there. That's going to be the defense holding again. CLG looking pretty strong here with under half of the amount of time left to attack A. For Rise Nation.
Yeah, 1:40 to go, but man, a quick pick by Retzy. Just guns him down. Perfect tracking there at distance. Not the easiest thing to pull off. And now, in the inside, looking for openings. Does drop low, though. Needs that heal to stay alive. He's got a tactical visor for this fight. Diva Bomb coming in, tries to get around the corner, engages with the aimbot, but already low, gets finished off by the Winston of iShiny. The defense continue to hold. Here comes the Rocket Barrage of Spirit. Only finds one kill. Hydration there to counter, has a barrage of his own. Lets it go on the point. Diva's got to deal with this. Can't eat it in time. Ends up falling. Will pop out of mech and self-destruct, but it doesn't matter. Another hold, and now only 1 minute to go. Might be the last push for an offense that does it. Joshi with 0 ults.
That's pretty rough for Rise Nation now. They got this slightly staggered kill there as well. It means they're going to be on the clock here, working against overtime potentially in this next stretch. And you can see the differences in the barrages in the last two pushes. Hydration was free and clear, no one able to shoot up, and he was a mile high again, so still managed to just rain down damage on those remaining tanks on the point, help his team secure the actual checkpoint again. Now it's going to be the attackers finding D.Va very quickly. Miso in a bit of trouble flies out of there.
Big flank maneuver coming in, but Hydration still alive and dealing with Retzy, forcing him back. Can he get that last rocket for the kill? Not going to happen. He will boop lock, I think, off the map. Did find him, but that allowed Retzy to go heal, come back around, get the kill. Now the res. Round number 2. Coming at you. Spirit with the hook. Will derail the Pharah, takes her down, back to Earth, and finds the kill. Spirit being focused, though. Indoors. Can he stay alive? Very tanky, getting a little bit of health. Survives for now. Gets the hook. Nails Waffletastic. Great pickoff to get this party started. Hydration not even likely to get back to the point. Miso, all up to him to stall. Has a little help. Retzy getting the benefit of the Lucio, at least for now, but they have a self-destruct. This could be enough to turn this fight around. We're into overtime. They've gotten about 2 ticks, but they need that last tick to come out if they're going to secure the point. Retzy, being dope, can he get the health back? Has the healing station, needs to get this aimbot off, and somebody has to stay on the point the whole time, but he's being pocketed, really just kind of laughed at by an enemy. It's Miso holding him back. Aimbot finally engaging, looking for the Pulse Bomb. Connects on Spirit. Waffletastic fighting the kill. Back onto the point. This defense still holding. They might full hold the first point, and indeed, starting to look like that will be the case. Nobody left. Completely shutting Rise Nation down.
That was ridiculous. Midnight managed to last as D.Va for like 1.5 minutes into overtime there. Pretty crazy. But actually was one of the last people to get taken out as well. So interesting from Rise Nation. They were unable to make the switches and find the kills that they needed. One team kill would have just been the difference there. I think they stood on the point for so long and just continually got contested. Mikado on the defensive Lucio was just there the entire time. I would love to be able to check out his objective time just on defense there, because he was doing an admirable job of course being a healing ward for his team and just preventing any additional ticks being captured there. So well done to CLG on the defense. Full hold on A is no easy feat against any of these top NA teams. So Rise Nation now going to flip sides and play for the draw at best. This could be a quick game one here if CLG just happen to have a nice entry angle.
And that is just mentally not a great place to be in when you know you're only playing for a draw. Then you have to go to a control point map where CLG have been pretty huge, at least on Oasis, with the Hydration, the Pharah Mercy combination. So I'll see, this is a real good test of their mettle, their poise as a team. That said, of course, they're not worried about advancing, so it's not that much pressure, but you know, you still want that better seed, and like you said, avoid a potential date with Rogue as they walk into Group B is very heavy favorites to take it.
Yeah, let's. I'm just looking at that group again here. Yeah, you don't want to be fourth place, assuming if Rogue are going to be on top. Obviously, they can get shut down by surprise as well, but Counter Logic Gaming, if they lose the series here, Rogue would probably be a high-odds playoff opponent. So CLG hanging on, doing a good job, doing their part on defense. Now they just have to find the kills here. Hydration's Pharah has been instrumental, as you mentioned, and maybe this time it'll carry them to a Game 1 victory.
See. Mikado just gonna throw out that quick Sonic Arrow, swapping right off, and away we go. CLG will start their offense with Hydration, sneaking over the rooftops on the right side of the map. Trying to use the sightlines carefully here. Doesn't want to be overexposed against a soldier, against an Ana, but will drive them pretty far back already in a very defensive position. Initially, they get the hook on Miso, though. They can DMAC him fairly early in this fight. That could be a game changer. About halfway towards the barrage, but the kills are coming out, and it's for the side of Rise Nation now, at least initially. Retzi doing some good work as the soldier. An unusual spot to hold as a defense, but it really limited the Pharah's flanking options.
Well, I mean, they collapsed to the point very quickly, and then where else is Pharah going to go, right? She has nowhere else to really be sneaky. On Eichenwald, you can jump right over the house on the left, or you can fly a long way around the right side. So if you just cut out those flanking opportunities and know that you can bunker down on the point itself, it seems to be a valid strategy. They have multiple tanks. They got the soldier to be able to shoot up at Hydration. He's going to swap over to Mei to try to react to this quad tank.
Are we going
to
see like a meta Athena boost now? Is that about to happen?
It's more to just provide line of sight. They can all spill onto the point, put up that May wall, and stand in the corner.
I think they're trying to boost here. Hydration, they're going to hop right over the ramparts down the other side. These guys that's watch so Korean Overwatch, that's for damn sure. They're going to sneak around now, but will it be as effective? It did work for Red Athena in the past. Now iShiny holding the high ground. The Maywall gets dropped. They still have yet to actually hop onto the point, yet to get a kill, and they are dealing with an Earth Shatter from a disadvantage, and the hook comes out. It's on the iShiny, who then eats the hammer. This is not how it's supposed to go. Not like this for CLG.
Just like you saw it coming, obviously the pro Overwatch players are going to see it coming. Like, they literally just sat there and waited for the Earth Shatter to be in the sweet spot, and it paid off. So how much time was burned off by them taking the right side, Maywall over the back, loop-de-loop, whatever strategy, where they could have just run straight through the choke and had the same thing happen?
Yeah, it wastes like easily like an extra minute to do that, and then you lose the fight. And now they've got a lot of ults here on the defense. Nothing doing for the offense. They're pretty close to an Nanovisor, fairly close to a Lucio ult, so they might have a chance, but it's not going to be an easy push by any means. Tactical Visor in reserve at the ready for Retzi. When does he unleash it? Oh, they lose their Ana early. That means no nano boost for this fight. Retzi hanging onto it. He guns down iShiny mid-charge. Great pick there on the Rhine. And now the stagger can begin. Waffletastic to fall as well. They even get the pick on Mikado. Does roll with the last hit. And now, with no ults really committed, this next push doesn't look a whole lot easier.
Well, just like on Gibraltar, sometimes both teams forget how to defend. On Eichenwald, sometimes both teams forget how to attack, and it's a lot of ults piling up. Generally, that is what's going to get the job done, but on the defense, they're going to be ready for it with a ton of ults on their own. So the engagement here is going to be very important here. iShiny, very close to an Earthshatter, wants to try and get up to 100% before engaging, for sure. Miso, Graviton Surge could also come in big here.
All right, iShiny, arching onto the point. Does get a big shatter off, then the charge drags Midnight away from the point, and that's crucial because Midnight has a grab. Oh, now we'll unleash it, catches Waffletastic and iShiny together, but is there anyone there to follow this up? It doesn't really seem like it yet. The Rhine nowhere near the point. Lock also not there, so this point looking completely compromised and likely to go down.
They all hit Q and they got what they needed. That Earth Shatter out there by Desro, very, very bad. Desro, I mean, obviously the match is complete. Point A is lost, so it doesn't really matter, but that was the desperation Earth Shatter. He wouldn't even have had time to get to the point, so it's okay. But 1-0 is going to be the score line, and CLG finally get it together. They hit all the buttons at once. That's really all you had to do. They outlasted the ults from their enemies. I want to call out Faz for contesting the point itself for so long, potentially giving Reinhardt a chance to get back in there with his Earth Shatter, but it was just not enough positioning and timing-wise, and CLG will take the first game over Ryze.
All right. Play of the game to Retzi here. You know, it's not often, Joshua, that you see the first point be the decider on this particular map. There was a little bit of it when the Symmetra Torb Cheese was in vogue, right. But since that's fallen off, generally teams get the first point. It's more, you know, at that third phase where the offense often grinds to a halt, but a very different result here in Eichenwald.
Okay, so again, we're aware of the potential of a three-way, 3-2 series scoreline. That means map scores would be the next tiebreaker if CLG wins this series. So CLG's map score right now is 6-4, while Ryze Nation's is 6-4. So this game will be able to break all those tiebreakers. If CLG wins, they're for sure going to be that third seed, and Ryze Nation would be the fourth.
All right. Yeah, thank you all for joining us. This is our last match of Group A in North America. Then we head over to Group B, which with the departure of Renegades from the tournament is looking like it should be a cakewalk for Rogue. Now, I would love to see that not be the case, just in the interest of some entertaining Overwatch, but at least on paper, you would imagine is the case. So, as we were discussing, coming up next, second match of the series, it's Kings Row, and it is going to be Ryze Nation starting off on defense.
All right, I'm actually happy to see Kings Row again. We have a pretty good map pool here, not too much assault madness going into tiebreakers. If I'm not mistaken, there were two assaults and two tiebreakers in one of the days of play.
Yeah, I think that was yesterday. There was two tiebreakers in one series, right? So
pretty rough. That series dragged out forever with the multiple Oasis tiebreakers, so happy to avoid anything like that. Kings Row does also have draw potential, though, if these two teams are playing much better defense than they are offense. Could see a 1-1 scoreline again, but Kings Row, again, every team should be vastly familiar with it, have a variety of strategies, be comfortable in multiple heroes, and you tend to get some really good Overwatch games on this map.
All right, so getting into our second game, could be the final one of Group A. Now entering. Anything unusual you're thinking of, Joshy? Like pick-wise, composition-wise? We've seen that, like, after you get the first point, hyper-aggressive offense backfire both times. It's like the reverse selfless, I guess. but, you know, that doesn't seem to be working out. So I'm curious if we get that on Kings Row or if these teams just stay away from it, play more standard three-man on the payload. Assuming they get the first point.
Just the sheer volume of games that have been played on Kings Row, we've seen it all basically at this point. Attacking Hanzos used to be a favorite to break down Reinhardt shields. That's kind of gone away as defenses have kind of moved toward back of the hotel instead, where scatter arrows are really just not as effective. They can't really do much. And you would pair it with a Zarya to try and get the dragon through the Graviton Surge combo, which is unblockable by barriers. So that had its heyday. You've had Sombra kind of dip in and out. Complexity, we're really big fans of it, and they seem to have dropped that as well by now. So Sombra, actually a bit of a rarity these days. I think as far as weird stuff, probably the most frequent to pop out still is Mei. You can see B does have him highlighted and might stick with it, but still pretty unlikely. I think dive comps in general have just been ruling the day for about a patch now, so everyone should be either on 3-tank soldier or dive comp by now.
All right. Well, still no idea what the offense is going to be running here, but generally it has been the Pharah Mercy for Hydration, though. And so it's going to be swapping over to the Zarya, something they do run on occasion. A little more often, though, we see the D.Va. I think they're probably the team that runs D.Va the most consistently. And Hydration, not playing the Pharah, will be playing the Hog. So this is definitely going to be a little unexpected. It's pretty rare to not see them run Pharah Mercy so far this tournament. Let's see if it works.
Yeah, it's going to be 3-tank soldier on both sides, and a lot of that is due to just the CC ultimates being potentially round winning. Earthshatter or Graviton Surge in the right spot can just completely win a fight. So that's what they're looking at here. Roadhog, of course, with no ultimates, can be an instant kill threat as well. Bionade comes in, and both Reinhardts are suddenly dead. Miso falls as well, so the attack is going to get stopped flat, I think.
Huge Bionade as Locke finds himself already at 60%. He's going to have a super fast nano boost to work with. Meanwhile, the struggling a little more in that department. So we are going to see Rise Nation hold off that initial push. Can they save it off round number two? They'll try, but this is not a great way to start it. If Midnight gets picked, will be charged. Self-barriers lives. They didn't quite have the follow-up damage. Rise Nation able to reset now. And Nano Visor ready for round number two.
1 minute burned off. They're going to be looking for their entry angle here. Eye Shining might actually charge, but he's getting very close to an Earth Shatter. So if he can just save up for a little bit longer, he can try to have those Rein mind games against Dezro, who's very, very far away from a Shatter still. Nano Boost on the defense is going to get committed on X Retzi. He gets laid flat as soon as he hits the button on the visor. Everyone on Rise is in such low health. They get just annihilated by the Nano Boosted Miso Zarya, of all things. She just grinds through them, and point A is done.
Eye Shiny is a hero. If that's not play of the game, then it should be. That was disgusting. That was what, like a four or five hero shatter to set things up? And they do it without the grab to initiate. And from there, completely waste the nano visor on the side of Rise Nation. So now, Payload's gonna start moving.
Okay, so the defense did die rapidly. Like, we talked about the split spawn issue before. All of the defenders are here at the choke already, but there's a flanking Roadhog. Hydration is in the backline, and Soldier's gonna find that out the hard way. Fortunately, Zarya's there to give him a bubble just in time. Graviton Surge on both sides comes flying out. There's a whole hog here from Hydration as well, pouring in the damage for the attacking team, and it looks like they're gonna come out on top. Once the bodies are counted, it's gonna be CLG victorious here. They just need to take out Spirit. No health left. Faz goes down as well, and that cart has a lot of mileage ahead of it.
Yeah, CLG looking strong in their opening onslaught. Cart will be moving, almost an Earth Shatter ready to go as they'll close in on the second checkpoint. I imagine we'll see one defense contest, but they do it with limited access to ultimates here and none of the big crowd control at the ready. No Earth Shatter, no grav, so it won't be an easy fight. Have to make sure that they block this likely Eye Shiny Shatter. He just wants to get off a good fire strike to set it up, but Spirit lays into him, gets the Zarya shield. Already the ride out of the picture, and his shield almost broken as Retzi holds the high ground, trying to force back Miso. Good hook. We'll set up the kill. Defense stabilizing. And now we're going to see a reset.
You can see how far back Eye Shiny is already. He knew that fight was going south very early. He started backpedaling with the shield up almost right away. Miso basically just threw himself in there to try and slow them down. There's a flanking Roadhog right now. Hydration is by himself. If they find him, actually they do. They find him all the way down in the subway and just blow him up. That's terrible for the attacking team, CLG. It's going to cost them another 20, 30 seconds.
I think I don't think he realized that they knew he was still in the neighborhood. Just kind of try to do that tracer thing, right? Where you hide and then you come back out, rejoin your team from behind for the next push. But I mean, talk about a stagger. That's like a solid 30, 45 seconds of time off the clock here. They'll get back to the point. They have the Earth Shatter. Let's see if Eye Shiny can make a play.
Well, it's going to be still the Rein mind games. Dezro is right
in the face,
but he
dropped
the shield right at the beginning. Why? Sound barrier is out for the defense. Nano Blade and Nano Visor both committed for the defending and attacking teams, respectively. X-Retzi not able to get the damage he's looking for. It's going to be mostly the tanks pouring in the damage. Hydration kind of unchecked there on Roadhog. Midnight, Dezro both fall, and it's going to be a couple of bodies on the payload here. Just supports, though, as Locke and Faz go down. That is going to be the checkpoint secured. They'll have a solid 4 minutes here for the final stretch.
This Rein works out. That's all I can really say, man. What a carry so far. Can't believe he's not on fire, actually, but yeah, he has hit two huge Earth Shatters, both of them just guaranteeing massive amounts of movement on the cart and objectives to boot. Now they have a Miso grab ready to work with for this next fight. Let's see if he gets a good setup. Trying to work with the hogs inside. Still searching for the right grab opportunity. Being patient with this one. Pressuring the hog back a little bit. Stays very far in the rear. Grab getting thrown out by Midnight actually to get the party started. And now Miso, extremely low, does get hooked. Holding onto his own grab. Doesn't end up going down. The Rein smash comes out but immediately dies. Will be denied here. Dezro kills off Eye Shiny. His Rein counterpart, but pays with his life for it. Coming in from behind, it's the Roadhog, but he also is picked off.
Somehow, CLG end up in that fight with four people still standing and a Graviton Surge ready to go. Spirit was the last one staggered. The Graviton's gonna fly out. X-Retzi, the only one caught in it, so it's a 5v5, really, on the cart here. Roadhog's trying to get in the action. There's a Nano Whole Hog from Spirit. That's a ton of damage and a very difficult to stop Roadhog. There's a Nano Boost onto Wappletastic using the Tactical Visor, and all the damage is coming in. Spirit is going to get pinned, and that should be CLG with the advantage.
All right, X-Retzy trying to play the hero here. Can he push them back? This is a great time to start the stall, and he'll get to. Now they can look to stagger iShiny. He wants to get back to the team, but he ends up realizing he's not running away from a sprinting soldier. Charges back in to the rockets and bullets. He will bring him down. So they stabilize. It would have been a pretty ridiculous offensive time had they lost that fight, but now we're looking towards more reasonable territory. About 2 minutes to go for CLG. They are going to swap here. Wappletastic now on the Widow.
Retzy got back just in the nick of the time with that Tactical Visor. He's the only one to die in the Graviton Surge, so the fact that he made it back when he did is huge for Rise Nation. And early on in this fight, you can already see the Ana being forced back. Spirit on the defense as Genji goes down first. Wappletastic and swapped over to Widowmaker. Genji got up in his face and still went down, and CLG are finding the kills they're looking for.
Yeah, adding a nice dimension to the offense. He's got a great position on the high ground. He's able to push the soldier into an awkward predicament where he tries to hide from the Widow, gets hooked instead, will go down, but can Wappletastic find those follow-up kills? They're going to need a few more if they want to push through. The has a Nano Boost. Anyone good to give it to? Not just yet, it seems, but Wappletastic now on fire, grappling back up, can really punish the Ryan as he tries to get back on payload. Looking for Desro, dropping the hammer, but it's not really the best Earth Shatter. Cart rolling in. That will be the time. 108, a solid showing here in the end.
Yeah, I think CLG can be happy with that. Obviously, they're going to have to take it back to the defense here, but they did full hold on Eichenwald, so it's a potential for them to try and wrap up the entire series on the defense. And finishing the map, of course, definitely helps going toward extra rounds. If they stop if they stop Rise Nation at any point along the way, they will be the map winners and series winners. So that would put them in the firm third spot seed for Group A. They're looking to accomplish just that, and now all they've got to do is roll through this this map here, or try and shut down Rise specifically.
All right, so how far can Rise Nation go? I guess that is really the question, and what tools do they look to employ to get there? We've seen Retzy switch around, I'd say, a little bit more than most DPS players. Like, Defran swapped when he needed to today, but Retzy, he swaps frequently, even when things are going well, if he just feels like there's a better tool in his arsenal. We've seen the Tracer, obviously the Soldier he's well known for, but definitely not afraid to mix it up. Looks like at least initially it is pretty heavy dive. They're gonna another thing they also like to do, which we're seeing right now, is they'll run the Pharah without the Mercy, a bit different compared to, like, say, CLG or LG Evil. So they're gonna play Spirit Pharah and Locke as the Zen to try and support it. One
shot. I'm fine with Zen coming out here. No Mercy does hurt a Pharah if the enemy team is running Pharah Mercy, but Mercy can actually be a bigger liability than Zen anyway if she dies with res in hand, whereas Zen can just pop his ultimate anytime to save his own skin. So there is obviously pros and cons to running either one. Res can be huge on these first points as well, but I think it's totally fine with Locke starting out of the Zen, and Widow, X-Retzy on Widow to start things off, probably will fire at least a few shots before switching, probably Soldier or Tracer, as we've seen in the past.
All right, so giving him a little bit of extra vision with the Sonic Arrow, and then says, nah, I'm not really liking the way this one's going. As I mentioned, always ready to switch. He's over onto the Tracer. He'll be looking for pickoffs here. Wappletastic holding back, trying to deny that upper quarter to the Tracer. She pushes in. Winston leading the charge, leaps up on the high ground, but reinforcements arriving. Hydration coming in as the D.Va now, trying to just bodyguard the Soldier as much as possible. Midnight also contesting. They really want to get the Soldier out of the cubby, but he's not being allowed to. They're not allowing him to do it easily. Spirit contesting. Has the rockets, working that Rhine Shield. Great way to bring it down fast. A lot of damage from him, but Hydration drops on the low ground, and that's when the Winston tries to strike. Desro jumps in. Get the hell off that ledge, he says to Wappletastic. But Wappletastic lives through it, able to heal him back up. He survives.
Wappletastic is like, nah, I'm good. I'll just stay up here. Spirit goes down there to Miso, which is kind of a rarity with the Zarya blasting out the Pharah. But the point itself is still being contested by Rise Nation. So CLG need to get back in here. Miso on the Zarya gets a little bit of extra charge, but is falling below half health now. Can they keep him up? Reinhardt shows up just at the last moment to protect Miso, but he does go down anyway. Desro also going to fall here. Means the CLG still have a chance if they get some ultimates to work with. Wappletastic dies before he can get Tactical Visor. Hydration just now going to respawn, or excuse me, just now reach the point. And is he going to pop his suit? No, he actually gets blown up instead, and that will be point A going the way of Rise Nation. 5 minutes on the clock for the second stretch.
I mean, for a second, that looked like it was going to be just a solid hold. Nobody was, I think the key thing you mentioned there, no one was on the point. Even when they had a man advantage, they just let them all respawn. They were trying to get all six back, and with the defenders' disadvantage on spawn position, by the time they did, damage was done. It was already like 1.5 ticks. They had the positional advantage. Defense kind of trapped an archway, and they get punished for it. So now, can they help mount a better defense, I guess? That's the question. Was iShiny doing huge work on Ryan on the first point, on the attack? Can he do it now on defense?
He certainly can. X-Retzi's already in the background forcing these defensive ultimates out. Transcendence and Soundbreaker both committed by CLG, but it is working out for them. iShiny hits an Earthshatter. Faz and Dezra both caught by it, so that should be an easy victory there. Now that Waffletastic has shown up with his ultimates, or his nano boost at least, is going to mow down everything else. Didn't have to actually use the tactical visor. Important to note that he hung on to it for the next push.
Oh man, that's clubbing time was really all I could think of. iShiny, he gets off the Earth Shatter and then felt like he did more work just with the Hammer Switch there. Gets three kills. Now round two though, they don't have to worry about that Earth Shatter, but the grab is available. Miso, waiting for an opening. He's going to grab it, connects on a few heroes. Spirit, he would love to get out of this and be able to drop his ultimate, but no Hydration! Coming in with a big D.Va self-destruct. Looked like the Pharaoh was going to live and be able to turn that fight, but now the spawn camp just riding them all the way back. Won't let them escape. No survivors. Pretty brutal bloodbath there.
Simple counting game when it comes down to should we rush their spawn or not. There's more of us than there are of them. We've just killed some. Let's go for more. And of course, they just know the timings to be able to back out. No, my goodness. Miso gets hooked in and booped away, so cannot be protected or backpedal. That was actually a really, really good alley-oop to take out Zarya from the fight immediately. And Hydration's going to lose his D.Va suit as well. There's a tactical visor from Waffletastic. Kind of out of position, though, gets bashed in the face by Retzi and company. Earthshatter comes out, and that's the first poor one that we've seen out of iShiny. CLG getting rolled now.
Well, never go half right. You know, it doesn't end up working out with the shatter. And he's like, you know, I could try to run away. I might get staggered. Better just charge in, die with the team, and commit to the shatter. But that means a crucial tool here for the defense. Not going to be available coming into the final point. Now, they do have to complete the map. But it's looking right now like they'll have a significant time bank advantage going into what could be point three. No big ultimates really ready for the defense, aside from that nano boost.
On the defense, you're right, Nano Boost is pretty much the only tool, but they are going to be able to contest here. Nano Boost onto Miso again. Did work out for them last time. Retzi's going to pop his tactical visor off the corner, but gets gunned down by D.Va and Zarya together. Dezro getting it booped far away from the cart now. Gives CLG a lot of leverage here.
Oh, that Midnight is so big. He's bad, and this Zarya is showing off those weightlifting skills. Finds three, looking for the fourth. Now he's been on close to 100 energy this entire fight. Great self-shield earlier to live through the Rhyne Charge, and now Waffletastic trying to get him with those right clicks. Can he finish off the soldier? Pow, gets him in the end. We'll secure the point. 3.5 minutes to go. Wasn't quite as fast as they would like as some free additional energy gets donated to that particle barrier. Already halfway back to his next hold. That is absurd.
Quite nasty for Midnight, yeah, all the way up to 50% as you mentioned, and they are going to get the first corner secured no problem. CLG are going to rush back in here. They've got only Waffletastic's attack visor to work with, so it's going to be a bit of a scary prospect. There's a whole hog out here from Spirit. He's actually going to get a little bit of speed as well to help force back that defense, but nobody dies to it, so perhaps committed a little bit early. CLG have time to fight back here with a sound barrier, Earth Shatter of their own.
And Waffletastic has an aimbot to work with. Not using it just yet. They want to bring down Midnight. They know this high energy is a problem. They can't keep on letting the Zarya live long through fights. Tried for a staggered retreat, but they might get staggered in the process. Relatively even back and forth there, but importantly for the defense, now it's about the time game, and they are getting it. However, they did not kill Midnight, who has another grab for this upcoming fight. Soldier on the high ground, though. Waffletastic with an excellent position to find pickoffs. You can't shield everyone from that angle. Faz getting focused down and will be almost finished off here. Not quite though. Finally, Midnight will fall. X-Retzi getting the pick. Took a while to take that soldier off the high ground though.
Faz leaps into the void there to rejoin his team in spawn. And right now, Ryze, they just need to group. Like, honestly, the ultimates that have been flying out the last couple of fights could have been blocked by barriers, could have been basically just backed out of. And it seems like by the time the fight's engaged, they just split up all over the place trying to find kills. While Waffletastic on that last round had a nano visor, very easily able to pick up the pieces. There's a hook into Hydration's D.Va shield to get this one started.
Hydration has the self-destruct. patiently hanging on to it. Is able to boop the Rein completely away from his team. What a great way to start the fight, opening things up for CLG. And now they can push forward. iShiny, very close to the Earthshatter as well. Gets hooked back by Spirit, though denied at the crucial hour. And now Waffletastic, not quite ready with his own aimbot, has to deal with X-Retzi, who is able to get one off. But Miso comes in, unloads with Azaria Ultimate, gets hooked again by Spirit, clubbed down by Desro, back and forth. Very scrappy battle for both teams. A Spirit tries to get away, barely around the corner. Looks like the D.Va bomb was almost still in line of sight there, but he is going to survive. Able to reset, at least for now. The cart, though, not moving all that much during this time. And speaking of time, becoming a bit of an issue here now, already worse than the time set by CLG, if they're even able to finish the map at all. Waffletastic, aimbot, nano boost, all of it committed, but he gets hammered down. It's denied. iShiny, again, doing so much for Shieldy, swinging that hammer for all he's worth, but he gets charged back the other way. He's dead again. By the way, Midnight has another grab, but they just don't seem to be able to get enough off of these grabs.
Tact Visor is such a good ultimate. It stays active even after you get Earth Shattered, so he still gets the damage pouring out. 24 seconds and a dead Midnight means Ryze is very unlikely to actually complete this map, especially with no ultimates on their side. We do have a Sound Barrier just now being finished up, but one Graviton Surge from Midnight could help Ryze Nation. Faz is about to have that Sound Barrier, so we've got a couple of ults to work with on the cart for their last attempt.
Ryan's already on the cart. He's also losing shield rapidly. Midnight finds the grab. Where's the follow-up, though? They drop the beat. They're very difficult to focus down. They don't have that combo damage just yet, but Desro swinging the hammer. Perhaps that's all they really need in the DPS department. D.Va pushing him back, though. Miso with a grab of his own. He's going to try to pull them away from the cart. This could be the end, but no, they managed to stay on it at least for now. Desro, Spirit, Faz, all staying strong. Desperately trying to get back to the point. Midnight has swapped over to the Sombra. Working on Miso, though. There's the Earth Shatter. In the background, though, D-Mech Hydration trying to focus him down as well. Blade is available. Spirit, it was a late swap, but it might be the right swap. Turning onto the Soldier, no Waffletastic says, meet the Tactical Visor. It's ready again. And they hold on the cart. Close, close to killing off Faz. They will do so. And here the cart stops in the end. Whew, tough
wow.
One, but they do hold.
Incredible stuff from CLG, 2-0 against Ryze Nation, who I think everyone had favored. Way to show up, CLG, for that seeding match. Definitely is going to pay off. If Rogue do, in fact, win Group B, they just saved themselves a very, very difficult playoff match by cementing themselves at 3-2. They did, I believe, lose to LG Evil, so they will be getting that third slot. But CLG avoiding a potential Rogue showdown is definitely worth it. Hydration with play of the match honors here on the D.Va suit of all things, getting the triple kill. I want to say Desro's shield was like so night and day in that match. Sometimes it blocked entire Urshad.